I'm here in Changsha today at Xpeng Xplan's event, which is an event where small groups of potential Xpeng customers come and are educated on NGP. That's the Navigation Guidance Pilot System, which is in the P7 Xpilot 3.0. So today will be potential Xpeng P7 customers coming here to experience and see what the system can do.
Xpeng's Xplan events focus on small group education around Xpilot 3.0 and more specifically NGP, Xpeng's answer to Tesla's NOA. With a maximum of 30 participants per session, the event is split into three sections. Small groups of 10 people attend each section in a round robin.
All right, so I'm now walking over to the Xpeng sign-in to sign in, give them my license, get all my paperwork from them and badge. So let's walk over there now.
Hello.
Once you've signed in, signed away your life, and been given your badge and X passport, you are ushered into your first of three sections. There's an indoor presentation, an outside demonstration, and finally, an NGP experience drive.
So I got my little pass, and a little passport book, and some documentation. The passport book, they're going to stamp it after each talk about each individual thing about the NGP. And then this is where later they will be doing the NGP talk.
The inside presentation revolves around educating customers exactly what Xpilot 3.0 software can do. They show slides that explain the advantages of Xpeng's NGP over Tesla's NOA, culminating in a side-by-side video comparison, showcasing the Xpeng's NGP's superiority in automatic lane changing and fewer driver interventions. They also focus on NGP's use of high-density mapping, something that Tesla's NOA doesn't use. Once the talk is over, the group is ushered outside to a staging area where Xpeng product specialists educate the group about Xpilot 3.0 and the P7. This part takes place as a strange kind of question and answer session. What will you do when you have an hour break after driving a long way for business? The answer is to use P7's meditation mode. And then they let customers sit inside the car and experience the meditation mode for themselves. Gentle sounds of nature while you sit back and relax. Next up, they compare Xpeng's little PAI voice assistant to Tesla's voice control. Now, in Chinese EVs, voice control and AI assistants are fast becoming a standard on any mid to high-end EV. And the Xpeng's little P does a really good job at controlling the vehicle. A bit of vehicle summoning and automatic parking demos against a BMW 3 Series. Some explanation about valet parking assist feature and how it can find and park in your safe space. Magical. Collect your stamps and your X passport to show you're a good little student, and we're off to the NGP drive. I'm not going to debate if Tesla or Xpeng software or abilities are better. The point of the inside and outside demonstrations are to show potential customers that Xpeng has its very own competent suite of autonomous functions. It's an event to better educate buyers on the aspect of their P7 offering, which may be difficult to do in a showroom or on a short test drive. The good stuff, the NGP driving experience. Two customers and a product specialist per car. Both customers have a turn using the NGP on the highway. The product specialist explains what the car is doing in real time. It's a great way to showcase their NGP and to really get a feel of the product for yourself.
Right, so now we're heading back outside to see the cars and to have an experience. So I don't know whether I'm in the group that's going to have the, you know, education of the capabilities first, or whether I'm in the group that is going out in the cars first. It was all in Chinese and I'm a little confused. So I'm just going to head down there now and we'll see.
Okay, so we're going to go for a drive. This customer's going to test out the NGP first, then I'm going to do it on the way back. Okay, so now we're on the motorway, and in a moment the NGP will turn on and it will follow the GPS. So now he's turned on NGP, his hands are near the steering wheel, but you still have to keep a hand somewhere on the steering wheel so it can feel that you are still there. You can take it off for a little bit of time, and now it's automatically doing its lane changes. So this is the map of NGP. It's like a detailed map, and it shows you what it's doing. So that was just merging between two motorways, off ramp onto another motorway, which it did without any problems. I mean, obviously for the first time it's a bit scary. So he's saying that in the 300 meters is going to be the exit of the motorway. So as it comes up to the motorway toll gate, it will disengage. That's going to go for its last one to come off the motorway. Okay. And there you go, it's now telling you that you are now back into control. Okay, so there we go. Okay, now we're in, it's going to drive by itself. Let's put my hand on it and it will do everything now and drive us back to the next ETC man. It's following the car in front. I have to wiggle the steering wheel every now and again just to let it know that you are actually paying attention. It's getting up to speed. Okay, so now we're going to go around this whole thing and it's going to do it by itself. This is actually quite nerve-wracking. Okay, so that I don't like. I mean, it wants me to shake it. Does it see that on the road? No, I won't see that kind of rubbish on the road. Okay. And then as it comes on, it's going to go. It knows. In fact, it's changing lane so it doesn't keep going right. On change lane left. So we've gone from one motorway to another motorway that splits into two junctions. And it's just navigated through that using the GPS, and it's done it all by itself. I mean, I don't have to do much. Wiggle the steering wheel every now and again. Be ready, of course. There we go. We have a wiggle. If you can hear that bong, that's what that's telling me. And if I don't wiggle it, it will start pulling on my seatbelt to remind me that I need to be paying attention. So it will start to pull at my seatbelt rapidly. It does it in a few different scenarios to jump the driver awake and make sure that he's paying attention. It does choose inopportune times though to ask for confirmation. Like then, just as we're merging, what's confirmation? NGP always maintains a distance of 5 meters between it and the car in front. That's the distance that it likes to work. We've given it plenty of time to react. LCC, you can follow as closely as, I think, 1 meter, maybe 2 meters. It's pretty easy. This would be much better to drive long distances on the motorway. So obviously, because it's not a human driver, it's not aggressive for lane changes and things like that, you know. Maintains distance, it will speed up slowly, not that slowly, but it will, it won't just, you know, go from 80 to 120 as fast as it can. It will slowly creep up time by time. I imagine why it asks you to shake the steering wheel is to make it harder for you to defeat the safety systems. So I know in like earlier self-driving or ADS car systems, you could buy clips on Taobao that you could just clip to the steering wheel or a weight, and then you didn't have to put your hands on the steering wheel. But by having to wiggle the steering wheel means that you don't, you're not able to just, you know, rest something like a bottle into the steering wheel and defeat the system. To turn it off, you just brake, or you just pull the steering wheel, you know, more directly. Okay, so now it's gonna take me off up to the ETC gate, and it will tell me in a moment that it's going to disengage. Here we go. There you go, 500 meters, it's going to turn off. So it's warning me, then 500 meters, NGP will turn off because I'm coming up to ETC gate. And when it does, it's going to give me a big notice on the instrument panel. There we go, it's 150 meters. Let's see. Okay. Okay, now it tells me, now it's up to me. Now it's pulling me. So the seatbelt will pull at you to remind you that you need to take over now.
So that's it, that's the event. A great way for Xpeng to showcase its P7 Xpilot 3.0 and NGP. Educating potential customers, showing them the different functions, and finally letting them experience a P7 with NGP cruising down the highway. With these advanced functions in modern EV vehicles, short test drives around the block just don't cut mustard. You can't educate someone on all of the features of such a tech-packed vehicle in such a short amount of time. And with the EV adoption still ramping up, a lot of potential customers have experienced smart EVs for the first time. They don't know what is available on the market or even what questions to ask. Showing them is definitely a smart way for Xpeng to get its point across.